Hi, thanks for stopping by my channel. In today's episode, we are looking at light switch plates. We are looking at three plates we are going to do. These are going to be a resin plate. These are my molds, and we are going to be a little creative. So I already set my 50-50 mix of resin. So I'm wearing gloves. When you do work with resin, wear gloves, folks, and make sure that you have a nice area that you're working in, preferably well ventilated, and then also wear gloves. And if you're sensitive, I would wear a face mask as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to pour this one first, and we're going to use four colors. So I have four little trays, and we're going to pour in our colors. This is going to be my base. So we're going to go a little high on that. And my base is going to be pink. Make sure you well shake it. And I use little skewers, and then I usually break them in half. And you don't need much. You just need a little bit. A little bit to change the color of it. And then you twirl it around, like so, to really get the color that you're looking for. And you just do it a little twirl. Just a little twirl. I'm going to keep going for this one a little bit more to really mix in the colors. I don't like that there's paint on the end of this one. So what we're going to do, once I have the color, I'm not going to use this one because it does have paint on it, and I don't want to mix the two. All right, so then we're going to pour a little bit. We'll move it over here. We're going to pour just a little bit because the stuff that we're using now isn't going to be very much. We're going to use a little bit of gold. Just a few drops, folks. Just like that. You see that? Just a drop. Really, really does the trick. You don't need much. It definitely changes the color. And you can use acrylics. You can use mica. You can use any really type of paint. You can also use household paint if you want to use whatever match your color of your house. I wouldn't recommend using inks. You can, but they're so see-through. So it depends on what your actual goal is. You might not want to use a see-through unless you're making something really cool. These are face plates. We kind of don't want them to be see-through. Now I'm going to pour a white. I well mixed it. We're going to drop that a couple drops in there. A little too much. So I put way too much in. So what we're going to have to do is we're actually going to have to pour more resin in, because for that mixture, we don't want that much. And you don't need a big stir stick for little cups. So we're just going to twirl it around, really mix it up. Really mix it up. There we go. And the final color we are going to use is this color. So we're going to pour in our colors. Just a few little drops. So this is going to need a little bit more. I just didn't probably mix it enough. I was just seeing what it was. So let's mix. Okay, now we're gonna drop one more drop in and squeeze, and there it goes. And we're gonna see what we get here. Looking for a change in color. It's kind of see-through, but it's okay because we're gonna put all this stuff in the bottom and then we're gonna lay it with pink. All right, so how we're gonna do this is we're gonna start with this one. So I'm just gonna color a little bit. Just pour it in spots, pour it in spots. Kind of be creative, kind of put it wherever you want. You know, and then we're gonna do the same thing with this. If you saw some of my other ones, these colors kind of look the same though. Unfortunately, I don't like that. So let's see what the white looks like on it. Let's give that a twirl. Let's put the white there. Let's go white there like that. Let's put a little gold in between that. Kind of swirl that around a little bit. A little gold action inside of that. Little white over in these spots. Just dabbling it. Because I like to be a little bit more free-flowing. You know, and I like to mix them up. Give them a little swirl techniques because when you swirl them, it really does look really cool when it comes out at the end. We're gonna pour a little bit. We're gonna pour like that. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna pour over here too. And we're gonna pour gold. Just like that now. Okay, and we're gonna swirl them around. Kinda swirl them around and just kinda see where they go. You know? We're gonna mix it up in a second with pink. But we're gonna make it a little darker. And to make it this color a little darker, you just add a little bit more. You know, you change the color by adding just whatever it gives up. Come on. More than what I thought it was gonna do. But I really want it to be a darker color. And to do that, you just have to add more. It changes the entire chemistry of it in a sense, you know, like the color is more dark now. You know, and then we're gonna mix it around. We're gonna put a little dark action into it. And we're gonna swirl it around just to give the resin just kind of a cool little feature here. Now what we're gonna do is pour our pink in. And you can see that there are bubbles. I was working on my vacuum pump, but it didn't work quite right, so I need to fix it because I was trying to work on building one. And then all right, so we'll just have to do the old-fashioned lighter technique, but I'm just checking them out. This is looking good though. And then I'm gonna do a swirl here as well. You know I like to do the swirls. So we're gonna swirl, and hopefully the pink kind of rides in. We're gonna see what that does. All right, there's that one. And let's light it up a little bit just so it quick and easy to fix just by taking a lighter to it. You can see all those little happy little bubbles go away. Now you can see some people use heat guns. I don't use them, but I have in the past. And then we'll do one more heat at the end. All right, so now we have a couple others, but I want to add a couple other colors to the mix. So let's like green. And we'll find one that's empty, like the pink here. I'm gonna add more into the pink because I like to reuse. So I'm gonna pour a little bit of pink. We're gonna do black, straight black for that one. And I just take that and dip it in. And then we'll mix it up. Just like so. Just like so. Perfect. And then we're gonna, because sometimes I use big, huge stir sticks, we're gonna break that in half just so I can use it for two, because I don't like to waste. We're gonna use another acrylic. We're gonna do green in the other one because we're gonna do a green and black. And we'll use some of this other stuff as well to accent it. So just dip it in, just, you know, get a nice little dip and then drop. And then we're going to mix it in. And that's not enough. So I'm not happy with that. That's way too light. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to drip some more in. And I'm back at it. And and you always just search for that color that you're looking for. You know, when you're dealing with resin, just add a little bit and it goes a long way. So you're just really just searching for that color that you're looking for. And that's much better than I was looking for. So what we're going to do is we're going to work on this green one right here. Yeah. Looks like there's a little piece right there. So I have some rubbing alcohol right next to me. I'm going to dab it away. All right. So let's use that white. Let's put a little dots here, little dot. We're just kind of dotting them around the corners. I think that's what we'll do. All right, and then we're gonna take our black. We're gonna mix it up a little bit more. We're gonna put it around it, kind of, not a flower, but how about on three sides of each little dot, just a little bit, or two sides, because we're going to swirl that around, because you know I love swirling, so I just like the look on it. If you don't, let us know in the comments below, what do you like to do? And if you made it this far in the video, why don't you think about subscribing? It really helps my channel grow. Right now I'm going for the whole 1,000 subscribers. So if you do decide to help my channel out by subscribing, it's absolutely free. I'd really appreciate it. And if you like the video as well, why don't you hit that like button? All right, so we are gonna do that. Then we're gonna mix the green up just to keep that green motioned. And I'm gonna put a little bit more white in there, I think, before I swirl it around. Let's put it in a couple more spots here. All right, so now we're gonna take an old one that we have over here and we're gonna use it to swirl, right? And then we're gonna twirl it down. We're gonna swirl a little bit and twirl it down. We're gonna swirl a little bit and kind of move it in a different direction, you know, so it's not, so the colors kind of blend together, kind of go their own way, kind of let the resin just go on a life of its own. Yeah, like that. Let's do that. All right, now we're going to make the faceplate green. So we're going to pour green in. Just like so. Just like so. We're gonna make sure it goes in all the spots we want it to go into. Just like so. We're gonna pour a little bit more in. Then we see that it needs to go in here too. So we're just gonna do that. We're gonna wiggle it around a little bit, kind of go high, go low, go high, go low, just to, you know, emphasize where it needs to go. I think it needs a little bit more right in the center. Just a little bit more, it looks like. We're gonna put a little black in there because I think I need a little bit more, but I think it'd be kind of cool if, you know, if we have some depth with the black. So let's do that. It's a metallic black, so it has a little kick to it. So we'll see what happens. And we're gonna swirl that in as well. We're gonna kind of put that on the back side. Let it, maybe it'll soak down. Maybe we'll give a nice little 3D effect. All right, it looks like that one is done. So what we're gonna do next is you take the lighter, and we're going to kind of burn them out. We're gonna burn them out. Burning them out. Okay, there you go. There's that faceplate. Let's give this one a little loving too. Might as well. Luckily, the bubbles for this one, when you do it, it is going on the backside, so it'll be less seen because this is a faceplate. So, not terribly a problem, but we'll see. Okay, we have one more, and we have some colors here. But this time I'm gonna make this one a little orange and black, kind of, you know, it's Halloween month, but I'm gonna use the green. You see, I'm just pouring that in, but this one is gonna be the mixture of the two. So we're going to, I'm gonna use this one. This one's a new one for me. We're gonna mix it up a little bit. Brand new, I haven't used this one before. So, but I think orange and black is a nice little contrast. And we want just a little drop of that. There we go. Okay, so now we're mixing that one up now. It has a little green in there still, so that's fine. Just keep mixing it up until you're satisfied. The resin is warm now, so it's trying to harden. It's trying to go through all its motions. This is gonna be less bubbles. It's more on the part of like, hey, it's cooking time, and I wanna, you know, be what I wanna be. So that's our orange. So what we're going to do is we're gonna do metallic on that side, like so. Okay, and we're gonna do our orange kind of like that just to start, and then I'm gonna swirl them around. Kind of so then the orange and the metallic kind of come together a little bit. So it's gonna be kind of, you know, orange on that side. And then we're gonna orange it on the other side of it. And we're gonna twirl them around so then they're together. Like so. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna pour the black on top. Kind of layer it a little bit. Just like that, folks. Just like that. And then we're just going to kind of make sure it goes on all our sides. And it is. It looks good. And I kind of don't want to swirl it too much because I've already done that. So we're just gonna do that and kind of wiggle the background a little bit. Like that. And I think we're done. All right. So what we're going to do now, folks, is we're going to wait for this to set. It's going to be a few days. And then I will finish this video at that point. So, okay, so it's been at least a week since I checked these. I had put them in the window because sometimes with resin, when the mold might not be right, or, you know, like the, it's just, it needs a little bit more time to cure. And I felt that they were a little flimsy at first. So I put them in the window to get that UV inside of it and for a little sun action. So what we're going to do is we're going to open these up. So the first one we're going to do, let's do this one here. And we're going to pop it open and see what we get. Okay, so the colors that it made, kind of like a camouflage one. So it's interesting. It's definitely, it's see-through in the sense of like you can see through it with the sun. And the middle here isn't see-through, but it's that camouflage. And then you can see the mica that we used. So the mica really did a nice little job. I kind of like it. I kind of think, I don't know how this would look on a wall because it is see-through. So as long as your hole didn't have, your wall was kind of shaped enough, this would actually be okay. So the backside needs a little trimming, just a little, so it's unsharp, you know, but overall, this one's pretty cool. That one's pretty cool. I'm going to put it over here and we'll zoom out after we release them all. Let's open up this one next. Pop it out. Wow. Okay, so there's a little my light. There's a little specks right here, but the color on this one, so you can see that there is little dots, like right there is a perfect example. You can see the little bubble marks, right? Well, now, I did just buy I tried to make a vacuum pump, and it didn't really work for resin. Like, it just was going to take me too long. So what I just purchased on Amazon, on that Prime Days, I bought myself a vacuum pump, and we're going to do a review of the vacuum pump, an unboxing of it, and I'll put that on the channel too, the one I bought, and then we're going to try that out and see if we no longer get bubbles. So these are just tests, but the colors on this one is really cool looking, and I don't think, if you're really looking at it, that it feels smooth where the little bubbles are, but I don't think that's going to cause a problem. And that's interesting that it did that swirl, like it has that center thing, but you won't see that. You don't see that on the front side. It has a real sparkle to it. So this one's pretty cool too, if you like the coloring of like the yellow and the black and stuff. All right. And then we have this one. And this one might go to someone who was requesting these colors. So we're going to see if what it looks like. I didn't like the other one that it popped out. So we're going to see what this one looks like. Okay. Here she is. Interesting colors. I don't know how I feel of it. I don't know. What do you guys think? It's definitely see-through. You can see my fingers through it. It's definitely see-through. But on your wall, it might look okay. I don't know, because you're going to see the light switch here. So I wish it was a little darker. So I might have to do one more run for the person. And it'd be kind of cool if I did it with the vacuum pump. And then we'll see, like, there'll be no air bubbles. Backside here, I don't see air bubbles. So that's cool. It is a little too see-through for my liking. So I might want to do it one more time for them and give them some options. But here it is. Oh, what are your things? What are your thoughts, folks? Do you guys like? Do you like? See, you can see how this one is. Like I was saying, that looks kind of camouflage-ish, and there's this. You know, it's taking that color because I have the background is green. So let's swap the color real quick with my little color palette here. Stay. I said stay. Okay, we'll use that to stay. All right, so you can see the yellow, and you can see how see-through that one is. But overall, really cool. I like the camo look, and I like that it's kind of see-through, but I might not want this for walls. I should probably put one up to see what it looks like on a wall. And you can see that one better. See how like the yellowish that it is? So it has some see-through to it. It has that like kind of fire-ish texture, but then it's really, really sparkly because of the mica. And, or actually, I don't think that was mica. I think that was the black because it was black metallic. I think that's what I had for that one. And I think I had mica for the other one. Let's fix this problem. All right, and so this one up against the yellow. See how you can totally see through it? So this one might not be good for a wall just because it's too see-through. So I think the next one we'll do is we'll make it so it's not see-through at all. We'll do a darker blue, darker pink for the background as the layer. And then we'll do a light. We'll actually try to do all darker. We'll try to put more ink. Because when you do these, you want to, you create the color by adding as much paint or as little paint as you want. Then it takes that background. What are your thoughts? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Hi, thanks for watching that last video. If you liked it, why don't you hit the like button? If you don't want to miss out on further content, please subscribe or maybe check out the video over here.